How can you insulate your existing walls with injection foam? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to discuss how we can insulate existing exterior walls with injection foam insulation. Before we get into that, go below, hit that like button for us. Thanks. So let's talk about how we would insulate a house with standard siding. And when I say standard, I mean either horizontal, vinyl, or aluminum siding. So what we do with that is about halfway up the wall, we take a single strip off around the entire house. After that, we drill about a 2.5-inch hole into each stud cavity. We then fill every stud cavity up with foam. Once we're done, we plug that hole and just put the siding right back on. Once we're done with this, with that type of siding, realistically, there should be almost zero trace that the crew was ever there. Now, if you have a brick home, what we would do is we would actually drill 3/4-inch holes in the mortar joints, and that's that corner of the brick and the mortar. So once we have these holes drilled and we drill them bottom, middle, top, 3 layers throughout the entire house, and we do that so that we get an even pressure and an even fill in those stud cavities. And once we're done, we actually inject mortar back into those holes. So like I said, this is a much faster, much cleaner repair process for the end of the project. So once we're done, again, and everything is remortared, there will be some time for the mortar to dry and age, of course, so it will stand out a little bit, but typically speaking, from the driveway and from the street, you can't notice anything. Now, if your home has wood siding, and that is a very broad topic because there are many, many different types of wood siding, but there are really 2 different ways to approach wood. One, we can drill through that wood, usually a 2.5-inch hole, and we would put a flush plug right in there. Afterwards, yes, that wood plug will stand out quite a bit. You may want to refinish, stain, or even paint over that plug to match the rest of the house. Now again, depending on the type of wood siding, sometimes we can successfully take that wood siding off. Of course, wood is usually not really designed to come off that well, so it can potentially cause some damage. So a lot of times, most homeowners opt to just have it drilled through and then cover it later to match over it, like I said, with paint or something like that. Now, if we're doing an install through drywall, what we do is we drill our standard 2.5-inch hole, of course, fill every stud cavity up with foam, and once we're done, the crew actually puts a plug in and the first coat of mud on for you. So we've talked about some of the more common exteriors that we see on houses, but keep in mind, if you have something a little bit more exotic or a little bit more odd on your house, odds are we've seen it and we can insulate it. If you want to learn more about insulating your existing exterior walls, please click the link below. Don't forget, subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.